Learn how to make neat line art in Adobe Illustrator with just one tool function. That's coming right up in today's tutorial. As designers, it's important to have a website to show off our portfolio of work. Bookmark offers the most straightforward and quickest way to generate an awesome website without even having to write down a single line of code, and all completed in a matter of minutes. Check out the link in the description below to learn more about Bookmark and design your website today. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. Remember, if you want to improve your skills as a designer, subscribe to Satori Graphics for weekly graphic design content. The very first thing that we need to do today is to apply a stroke color without a fill, and then choose your shape. Making line art with this tool function works pretty well with any shape that you want to use, but I'm first going to run with an octagon. And to make an octagon, take the polygon tool, click on the canvas, and type in 8 sides. All of the magic for your line art is going to happen right here under the effect, distort and transform, and then the transform window. Firstly, click preview so you can see your effect changes in real time, and then increase the amount of copies. For all of these settings today, you should really experiment with them and see what fits best for your line art design. Also, don't forget to have fun with it, of course. But it's best to lower the horizontal scale a tiny bit, and then you might want to check or uncheck the scale, stroke, and effects button. Leaving it checked will fade the inner part of your design, which you will see later. And like I said, guys, play around with the settings because you can make some seriously interesting designs with ease. But I will show you the one that I have the most fun with later in the video. For the angle, I find it helps to double click the measurement numbers and then simply just press up and down on the arrow keys on your keyboard. This will slowly change the effect of your design, like so. With shapes that have many different sides, such as hexagons and octagons, you can make some cool kind of horny shape designs by playing with the vertical and horizontal move sliders. When you have your shape set, press OK and then click the stroke in the color palette so you can edit the colors. However, if you wish to add a gradient to the line art, you need to go ahead and go up to Object and Expand Appearance, and then again into Expand. As you can see now, my line art design has a gradient across it, and this would look pretty dope on a dark background. But we're going to move on to the next shape, which is using a square. I feel you can make the best designs with a square, alongside utilizing the rotate tool. So access the rectangle tool in the toolbar, or you can press M on your keyboard, and then generate a square on your Illustrator canvas. Like before, head into Effect, Distort and Transform, and then Distort. This time, the top two sliders really need to have the same values, and quickly, just to show you, look how easily you can make some complex and intricate designs with this function. It really is awesome. But for this line art design, keep your move sliders to 0 and central, and then play with the angle by double clicking the measurement numbers and then using the arrow keys like before. You will notice that if you uncheck the scale stroke option, the design was going to fade into the middle. You can choose whichever setting you want for your line art design. Before you go ahead and expand the appearance of your design, you can increase or decrease the stroke weight. Remember that after you do expand the appearance, you're not going to be able to edit the stroke weight. So it's best to do that beforehand. Finally, press R for the rotate tool and then hold down the Alt Option key and click the very middle. You can type in a rotation value, keeping it within a multiple of 360, so for example 36 is good. Then click copy, and all you need to do is press Command or Control D to repeat the process. you will notice that this is a lot like a spirograph, you know, these cool circular things that you use with pens and paper. So have fun with the Illustrator transform function in this way and get creative with it. You can of course use your line art designs in many different ways, and you can even transfer them over to Photoshop like I did with my design here, and add stuff like a lens flare and other effects too. Remember, if you want to improve your awareness and your skills as a designer, subscribe to Satori Graphics for weekly graphic design content. Like and comment on this video if you did enjoy it, and if you really found it useful, share it on social media to help out my channel and to boost awareness of what I'm doing here at Satori Graphics. I'm going to be back tomorrow with yet more graphic design content, so stay tuned, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.